Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Bay Area Focus. I'm your host, Michelle Griego. Today, we'll talk about a program blending baking skills with job training, an initiative empowering young girls, and a nonprofit providing health and wellness services to Bay Area Latinos. But first, an in-depth look at the Jewish Community Center's Arts and Ideas series. SF Chronicle movie correspondent Ruth Stein and Arts and Ideas director Barbara Lane are here to highlight upcoming events. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks for having you.
There are so many events to talk about. Tell me the ones that stand out.
Well, we have a very eclectic program at the JCCSF. And by the way, you do not have to be Jewish. I want to make that very clear.
Okay.
We have everything from circus to dance to live music to great authors and political figures and scientists. We're going to talk about Ruth's Jewish life in American cinema, but we also have programs coming up with esteemed anchor Leslie Stahl. We have political strategist David Axelrod. We have comedians. We have everything you could think of. So as I said, it's very eclectic, it's very robust, and we welcome everybody.
It speaks to all audiences.
Absolutely.
And you have some really great guests coming up, but you've also had some really great guests in the past.
We have had, my favorite interview ever was with John Updike, because I love great literature. We've had photographer Annie Leibovitz. Okay. We've had Mark Morris, the choreographer. We've had Tom Brokaw. We've had Isabella Allende, Isabella Rossellini. So we have a real starry sort of cast of people who've come through the doors of the JCC, but we also have people you've never heard of, mm-hmm, telling you incredibly fascinating and interesting things about everything, as I said, from brain science to animal behavior. So all you have to do is visit our website and you'll see our offerings, and I can guarantee you there is something for everyone.
Something for everyone. We love that. All right, well, let's talk about film.
Absolutely. It's always fun to talk about the movies.
Yes, definitely. There are many films about that focus on the Jewish community.
Yeah, there are, and there's a very good reason for that. The entertainment business in Hollywood has been populated by Jewish producers. When movie studios first started, even before like the 1920s, they were mostly headed by Jews as well. And they have had many, many, many writers and directors who are Jewish, and they're very interested in telling their own stories. Probably the example most people will relate to is Woody Allen, who in Annie Hall told a wonderful story about what happens when a Jew and a non-Jew get together and they're really, really worlds apart.
Any lobster,
right. And the Coen brothers, who in a film called A Serious Man, really took on what it means to be a Jew in contemporary America. And I have another great example that just occurred to me this morning. Barbara Streisand, whose films are going to be very prominently discussed in this program that, mm-hmm, myself and former film festival director Peter Stein are giving. So Barbara Streisand, she first made a movie. It was called Funny Woman. That was her first movie in Hollywood, and it was based on a Broadway musical, and it was about Fanny Bryce, who was a very famous Jewish musical comedy star in the 1920s. And then Barbara Streisand went on and did The Way We Were with Robert Redford, another example of when a Jew and a non-Jew come together and what, sure, happens in terms of clashes. And then we're bringing her up to the modern time, to a movie that she did with Seth Rogen called The Guilt Trip, in which she plays a very stereotypic but very funny and clever Jewish, mm-hmm, mother. So these are the films that, among many, many films we're going to be showing that illustrate really life in America. Of course, when Tinseltown takes that subject, they kind of look at it in a certain filter. But even through that, you can see a lot of reality in it. Mm-hmm. And you know, when Jews meet Gentiles, it's interesting to me that there were a bunch of these films that happened in the 1960s and 70s when interfaith marriages were just starting to happen. I mean, they'd happened before, but there'd been in very few. But with the assimilation of the Jewish culture, the second generation Jews, there were a lot more of them. And so these stories were told on screen, But we haven't seen a movie like that in 30 years because it's a non-issue now. I mean, there's been so much interfaith and interracial marriages and nobody really thinks about them anymore.
Sure.
So they served a purpose at that time.
How do you choose the themes in the series?
Do you mean themes within the Jewish experience? Well, Peter and I just sat down and kind of thought, okay, well, what are the important things that people will be able to relate to about seeing Jews on films? And we got to the Jewish stereotypes and we got to the intermarriage part of it. We had a segment about when Jews party, when we were talking about these lavish bar mitzvahs and weddings, again, happened during the 60s and 70s because Jews were getting wealthier, they're more prominent in business, they had money to spend and throw on their children. Jewish comedy, which is the last program we're going to be doing at the JCC, where we have not just like we have all the funny comedians, but we're doing a whole segment on Jewish women comedians, including Barbara Streisand. I think she's a running theme in our festival.
Oh,
actually.
Yeah, she's great. Well, thanks so much for coming on the show and telling us about everything
you
have to offer. Should be great. For more information on the Jewish Community Center's Arts and Ideas series, please log on to jccsf.org. Again, that's jccsf.org. Coming up, a bakery production program that's opening doors for low-income residents in the Bay Area. We'll be right back.